Today we will discuss the most important part, the definite integration. Definite integration is just the after the indefinite integration. Look at if integration of f x dx is equal to g f x plus c. If integration of f x dx is equal to g x plus c, then integration from a to b f of x dx equal to g of x plus c, and it is after a to b. You put the value b in place of x, next the value a in the place of x, so that is equal to g of b plus c minus g of a plus c. And look at the c term will be cancelled out, that means g of b minus g of a. Look at the definite integration is always free from the constant of integration. The definite integration is always free from the constant of integration, right? Come to one example. Example, integration from 0 to pi by 2 cos x into dx, first bit. Second bit, integration from minus 1 to 2 x cube into dx, third bit. Integration from minus 1 to 1 x square plus 1 into dx. Now we will discuss it one by one. Look at what is the integration of cos x into dx. What is the integration of cos x into dx? Cos x integration is sin x root of sin x plus c, and it is from 0 to pi by 2. In place of x, we write pi by 2, so it is sin pi by 2 minus sin of 0. See, you have function that is equals to 1 minus 0 equal to 1. Next is, here is the integration of x cube. It is x to the power 4 by 4, and it is from minus 1 to 2. So this is equal to 1 by 4 into 2 to the power 4 upper value minus minus 1 to the power 4, it is 1 by 4 into 16 minus 1, that value is 15 by 4. Look at, here is the two terms, x square integration is x cube by 3 plus 1 into dx is x, and it is from minus 1 to 1. You put 1 in place of x, so 1 cube by 3 plus 1 minus minus 1 whole cube, each one minus 1 by 3 minus 1 in place of x, we also write minus 1. So it is 4 by 3 plus 4 by 3, it is 8 by 3. This is all about the general form of the integration, general form of the integration. Now come to another type of definite integration. When we substitute, how to use the definite integration? When we substitute, how to use the definite integration? Use of substitution. Integration from 0 to 1 x square plus x plus 1 whole to the power 5 into 2x plus 1 into dx. This is first bit. Second bit, integration from 0 to pi by 2 sin 4x into cos x into dx. Third bit, integration from 0 to pi by 4 root over of tan x into sec square x into dx. Come to its first bit, look at x square plus x plus 1 derivative is 2x plus 1. So you substitute here, x square plus x plus 1 will be taken as z. Let z is equal to x plus 1 implies dz by dx is equal to 2x plus 1, and what will be dz? Dz will be 2x plus 1 into dx. Right? Now look at, here the variable varies from 0 to 1. X variable varies from 0 to 1. When you substitute, this will be completely in the form of z. It will convert it to z form. Z is another variable. So when x varies from 0 to 1, where z will vary? Look at, if x is 0, if x is equals to 0, what is z? Z is 1, 0 plus 0 plus 1. If x is equal to 1, what is z? 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. So integration from 0 to 1, this much value will be reduced as to what? Now integration from 0 to 1, x square plus x plus 1 whole to the power 5 into 2x plus 1 into dx, it is equals to integration from 1 to 3 z to the power 5 into dz. Look at, when the variable changes, the lower and upper limit also changes. When the variable changes, the lower and upper limit also changes. Z to the power 5 integration is z to the power 6 by 6 and it is from 1 to 3. Look at, we put the proper value 3 to the power 6 minus 1 to the power 6 by 6. That is 729 minus 1 by 6. And the value is 728 by 6. After simplification, the value will be cancelling with 2, the value will be 344 divided by 3. This is the answer. Similarly, you take here sin x as z, this will be dz, cos x dx will be in the dz form. Now we come to the second big question. Second bit is integration from 0 to pi by 2 sin 4x into cos x into dx. You substitute here, u equal to sin x, du by dx is equal to cos x, and du is equal to cos x into dx. This is the value. Now when the variable changes, lower and upper limit also changes. When u equal to 0, when x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, sin 0 is 0, so u is equal to 0. When x equal to pi by 2, sin pi by 2 1, so u is equal to 1. So u varies from 0 to 1. It is integration from 0 to 1, u to the power 5 into du. And this is equal to u to the power 6 by 6, and it is from 0 to 1. 1 by 6 into 1 to the power 6 minus 0 to the power 6, finally it is 1 by 6. This is about the second bit. Now we will go to the third bit. Third bit of the question. Now come to 0 to pi by 4 root over of tan x into sec square x into dx. Put tan x is equal to z, z is equal to tan x, dz by dx is equal to sec square x. So what is dz? It is sec square x into dx. Now if x is equal to 0, what is z? Tan 0. Tan 0 is 0, so z is 0. Now if x is equal to pi by 4, if x is equal to pi by 4, z is equal to tan pi by 4, it is 1. So it is integration from 0 to 1 root z into dz. Z to the power half plus 1 means 3 by 2 by half plus 1, 3 by 2, and it is from 0 to 1. 2 by 3, 1 to the power 3 by 2 minus 0 to the power 3 by 2. Finally it is 2 by 3. It is the answer. So this is all about the substitution. Keep remember that when the variable changes, lower and upper limit of the definite integration must change. Otherwise the answer may be wrong. Now come to one more type. That is Wallis formula. Wallis formula. Wallis formula. Integration 0 to pi by 2 sin n f x dx equal to integration 0 to pi by 2 cos n f x dx. This is equals to n minus 1 into n minus 3 dot dot 2 or 1. This is divided by n into n minus 2 into n minus 4 dot dot 2 or 1. This into pi by 2 if n is even, and this into 1 if n is odd. Remember that n must be a natural number. Right. This is Wallis first formula. Come to the second formula. Integration 0 to pi by 2 sin b x into cos q x into dx. Its value is p minus 1 into p minus 3 dot dot 2 or 1. This is one bracket into q minus 1 into q minus 3 into dot dot 2 or 1 divided by p plus q into p plus q minus 2 dot dot 2 or 1. This into 1 if pq both even. PQ both even. This into pi by 2 if PQ both even. And into 1 otherwise, means 1 even word or both or case, it will be 1. If PQ both even, then this will multiply this with pi by 2. If PQ 1 even word or both or, then in case this will be this into 1 or probably this value only. No, pi by 2. Now, look at. Here is a trick for you. We just eliminate or subtract the odd numbers in the numerator, even numbers in the denominator. So you must remember that O by E, odd minus divided by even minus. This is the trick for Wallis formula. Come to one short question for this. Integration from 0 to pi by 2 sin 10 x dx. Sin 10 x dx. Look at 10 is even. So we multiply this with pi by 2. And n is here 10. So we write 10 minus 1, 10 minus 3, 10 minus 4, 5, 10 minus 7 into 10 minus 9. Because no even, no 0, no even. No negative, no 0. No negative, no 0 means after 1, you must come up to 1, not thereafter. Put it. 10 minus 11, it will be a negative number. So you cannot go beyond after 0. We will go up to 1. Next, denominator is 10 into 10 minus 2, 10 minus 4, 10 minus 6 into 10 minus 8. No, 10 minus 10. 10 minus 10 will be 0. We cannot go up to that. This into pi by 2. This into pi by 2. So it is 9 into 7 into 5 into 3 into 1 divided by 10 into 8 into 6 into 4 into 2 into pi by 2. 5 cancel with this, it will be 2, and 3 cancel with this, it will be 2. So it is 63 pi by 512 is the answer. So this is about the Wallis formula. Now we'll jump to another type.